Hello students, today we look at the 8th experiment, which is time division multiplexing. Time division multiplexing is a technique that is used in communication a lot. We can understand the basic concept of multiplexing by looking at this diagram. Suppose there are n senders, sender 1, sender 2, sender 3, like that, n number of senders are there. And there are n number of receivers, but in between there is only one communication medium that can be a single wire which carries electronic information from one point to another. If all of them simultaneously want to communicate, there is a requirement of bringing the information of sender 1, sender 2 and sender n all the way together and put them together in a single shared medium. For doing that, we use a multiplexer. This is the simple circuit diagram of a 2:1 multiplexer. Here there are two signals which need to be multiplexed. For that we are having two switches S1 and S2. The switches S1 and S2 are connected to the clock, wherein signal S1 receives the clock signal and S2 receives the inverse of the clock signal. That means when the input at S1 is high, at S2 it will be low. Simply put forward, what we have here is a switch S1 and S2 system, in which when S1 is on, S2 will be off. When S2 is on, S1 will be off. How we operate it is that when S1 is on, the input signal will pass through and be dropped at the resistor, because of which we will get at the output the signal coming from switch S1. In the very next instant, when S1 is switched off and S2 is switched on, we have the condition that input 2 will pass through switch S2 and be dropped in the resistance, because of which we will get at the output the signal from input 2. This can be accomplished using a switch which is obtained in CD4016. As you can see here, CD4016 has four different switches, switch A, B, C, D. We can use any of the two switches as switch A or switch B. The output, the multiplexed output, the TDM output, will be obtained as shown in this figure, waveform diagram. You can see that at the instant when the clock is high, the part of the triangular wave will come outside. When the clock signal is low, it's the output that is made of the square waveform. So here in this signal, the last signal, it is a combination of both the two signals that are given at the input. Now you might be confused that there is no sign signal. It can be any message signal. For this diagram, we have just shown a square wave instead of a sine wave. So in this circuit diagram, we have in the center of the circuit CD4016 IC, in which switch 1 is the input, pin 2 is the output of that switch, and pin 5 is the controlling pin of that particular switch A. Similarly, 4 is the input, 3 is the output, and pin number 13 is the control for switch B. The circuit can be used for time division multiplexing. For NOT gate, we are having IC7404, which has 6 NOT gate ICs. We can use any one of these 6. That can be pin 1 and 2. Don't forget to connect the power supply of the IC7404. Thank you.